So a lot of hype went into the Epic React. Nike touted it as the best midsole and they're reinventing foam, being more cushiony, springing and all of those kinds of things. Honestly, I don't even think it even lives up to half of that. This is a beautiful shoe. It is probably the best looking silhouette from all running shoes, especially long distance running shoes out there. So, so good looking, it's like the prom king and queen in the class, you know. They might not be that smart, but they're so pretty, we like forgive them for their shortcomings. And this is like one of those. Even though I don't dig this shoe and I think the shoe is overrated, properly overrated, I still keep it in my shoe rotation, I still wear it. So they're still pretty cool looking and I wear this casually more than anything. Look at the upper, I mean the Flyknit is Flyknit, nothing really fantastic. What I don't necessarily like is that the shoe, although it's a long distance shoe, don't expect it to be responsive. It just isn't at all, so don't even expect that. So what I think they did really well is just how this ankle collar fits around your foot. It's really nice and snug and it fits super comfortably, but it doesn't necessarily lock down on your foot, so it's kind of pointless in the end. So then there's a bit of plastic over here, which I really don't know what the point is. Maybe it's to provide some more stability to like the overall shoe, but honestly, I don't really feel it. I don't even dig it. It seems pointless to me. Then there's this all important midsole. This is Nike's answer to Boost. I mean, Hover's also in the mix right now with a foam material, and there's obviously the fresh foams from New Balance, but honestly, I really think these were overhyped completely. Now, most people look at the midsole proprietary materials from big brands and they think, okay, cool. Automatically, you jump to the idea of cushion plus energy return and kind of springiness. And honestly, when you wear the shoe, just like walking around, there's oodles of that. It's got that foot in clouds kind of marshmallow kind of feel where you feel that soft cushion as you're walking and it's springy. Perfect, especially when you're walking. But as soon as you go to the run, that all just disappears completely and becomes super flat. And there's just no feedback from the shoe. It is boring and really, I don't know, I think it's just a better way to spend your money. If you look at the outsole, there's not much. Originally the shoe comes with a nice gelled outsole, but after like one or two runs, that's kind of pointless. It just disappears and becomes this brown kind of gum looking thing. And then there is the rest of the shoe, which is mostly midsole. And you can see for me, my impact zones are basically mid kind of footish. And it kind of ate right through that midsole. It's not really great. So yeah, again, clever design, really pretty, looks great coming out the box. But as soon as you go in the functional, it's okay. Nothing kind of happens here on the high abrasion areas where you expect it to kind of like hit with your forefoot or in the heel, and literally your midsole, which is kind of what you're running on, gets chowed. So again, I don't know. Nike, I had such a lot of hope for this. I mean, it looks great, so you think, perfect. I mean, this will go well in my collection and you can wear it casually and to the run. But on the performance wise, I think there's so many other shoes from Nike that are better than this. And I really think it's a bit of a failure. The fact that they introduced the Epic React 2 a year later with no real changes except for a bit of coloration in the midsole and some new colorways, pointless. Save your money, buy something else, honestly. For those of you who like a pretty shoe, I get that. I mean, I like that as well. It's just doesn't match up with performance and performance of the other brands. And I really think there's other Nikes that are better from a long distance perspective. And if you're looking for better cushioning, I'm sure something else works much better. Or go to one of the other brands. I think the Solar Boost from Adidas is great. There's a couple of other shoes from Under Armour that's fantastic with regards to the Hover technology. I mean, there's just so many other shoes that I would choose above the shoe. This actually falls all the way to the bottom. Only reason I keep it around, like I said, it's really pretty and I'm willing to forgive some of its shortcomings, actually all of its shortcomings, because it looks so cool. I mean, I could just rock this on a quick errand and to the gym, whatever, but I don't necessarily like actually doing anything athletic in them besides walking, which is not really that great. But yeah, in a nutshell, pretty looking shoe. Doesn't really do what it's hyped up to be. I'll put a link to that Nike advert and the video of it and how much it kind of sold this as being the next reinvention of cushioning, whatever. But yeah, save your money, buy something else.